President Yoweri Museveni commissioned the All Saints Cathedral Nakasero in Kampala today, calling on Ugandans to avoid disunity and interfaith conflicts. Museveni said that if it had not fought and rejected sectarianism during the Bush War in the 1980s, the fighters of NRA would not have been able to build a strong force that overpowered Milton Obote's government.
I am never impressed by people who say they are Christian, they are this and that. But if you say the way they are living, they are not living a good example, a good life for themselves, and a good example to the others. Judge people by what they do, not the label, the denominations where they worship, where they do this. Because then how do you handle the parable of the Good Samaritan?
The multi-billion shilling construction project, which began in 2011, has been a focal point of religious expansion in Kampala, with the cathedral designed to accommodate a growing congregation of over 5,000 worshippers. The cathedral, which is nearing completion, includes four chapels, offices, and a 45-meter bell tower. According to the Archbishop of Uganda, Dr. Stephen Kazimba Mugalu, who is also the Bishop of Kampala Diocese, the church still needs close to 6 billion shillings for full completion, particularly for the exterior.
Thank you so much for supporting us to clear the Janani Room Church House debt. Now we are debt free. And we thank you so much, Your Excellency, even for directing the Minister of Finance to compensate us for our land at Entebbe and at Makerere. That one helped us a lot.
Museveni said that he and the First Lady contributed 100 million shillings towards the church. He further promised an allocation of 1 billion shillings in the next budget of July 2025. A section of artisanal gold miners have protested the decision by the security committee to close a new gold mining site at Bulamba Ward in Namayingo Town Council. They are, however, asked by the district security's move to cordon off the site, ordering them to vacate the area. Sharif Makoka, the deputy speaker of Namayingo District and the area youth councillor, detests the move by the district security authorities, saying that the site has created jobs for unemployed youths.
Basing on how these mines have been so helpful to us, we have women who have gotten loans from village savings. They have opened up smaller hotels here and other businesses. Just yesterday, today they are chasing them away.
The community themselves found the gold ore themselves. You get it. Apparently, the person who claims to be a license owner only has an exploration license. They don't have the mining license.
Sefasi Wanjala, the zonal mineral in charge police commander Eastern Region, said that the move is a directive issued by the Minister of Energy and Minerals Development, adding that the mining activities are illegal. Kenya today swore in Kithure Kindiki as the new deputy president after the historic impeachment of Rigathi Gachagua. This follows weeks of drama around the impeachment of Ruto's previous deputy. Rigathi Gachagua was accused of ethnically divisive politics. A powerful businessman, Gachagua helped Ruto win a closely fought election in 2022 by rallying support from the crucial Mount Kenya region, particularly members of the Kikuyu tribe. But he fell out spectacularly with Ruto, not least by showing support for this year's protest. Kindiki, a 52-year-old academic and lawyer, hails from the vote-rich Mount Kenya region. He defended his boss at the International Criminal Court when Ruto was accused of crimes against humanity over the 2007-2008 post-election violence. In his acceptance speech, Kindiki described himself as the most unlikely person to take over the deputy presidency, having come from humble village origins.
I want to commit to you, before this congregation and before the Almighty God, who is acknowledged in the Constitution, that I will serve under you and provide you with the assistance and support you require to take this country to the next level.
Professor Kindiki is a highly qualified and outstanding scholar, advocate and public servant, whose career has been defined by exemplary achievements which demonstrate his vision for positive change and commitment to high standards of efficiency in the performance of his duties.
Kindiki was criticized for backing the police when they were accused of excessive force during the protest.